Well, now a News 8 special report on wounded troops coming home from Iraq and Afghanistan.
It's not easy to see, and in fact, it's not something you usually get to see, but a Susquehanna Valley man is in charge of the mission that welcomes wounded troops home.
He invited News 8's Janelle Stelson to Andrews Air Force Base, the first U.S. stop for every injured military man or woman coming home to heal.
Prepare to lift, lift.
It's a different kind of military maneuver.
Prepare to lower, lower.
Executed with precision and compassion. It's not on the front lines, but helps those who are.
22-year-old male with paranoia and anxiety.
At roll call, you don't want to hear your name.
With amputation above the knee.
But when the call to action comes, Army Colonel John Maietta of Mechanicsburg, Cumberland County, moves out fast.
That's good. This is such an extraordinary opportunity for somebody like myself who's been in uniform for 36, going on 37 years.
He leads his army to a different kind of battlefield.
I like to say it's about as close to the front lines as they'll let a 57-year-old colonel get.
But here on the tarmac at Andrews Air Force Base, it is still all about fighting and life and death. Every U.S. troop injured in Iraq or Afghanistan re-enters the country here. They are Colonel Maietta's mission.
To three times a week meet and greet and assist some of the greatest Americans we'll ever see.
Security here is so tight, we are not allowed to show you more of the outside of the plane he is meeting. That's because Air Force One, the president's plane, is parked nearby. But we can give you a rare look inside.
Hey, welcome home. How you doing? Can't give you much, but I can give you an extra phone card, all right? Hey, good luck. Take care.
This modified C-17 medevac transport plane is what has kept some of these troops alive on their flight home from Landstuhl, Germany.
The aircraft that these soldiers fly on are literally flying ICUs, intensive care units, especially for the critical care soldiers.
A medical team of at least three, a doctor or surgeon, an anesthesiologist, and a nurse flies with each of the troops. But it is still tough traveling.
He's been through five time zones. He's tired, he's stressed, he's confused.
This airman is also flying with his wife. His leg was blown off by an IED in Iraq.
I'm just excited that he's alive. I'm happy. Whenever I seen him afterwards, it was the happiest day of my life.
Few of the roughly 20,000 men and women who have taken these flights in the past 4 years can walk off on their own. That's when Colonel Maietta's team really goes to work.
In the Army culture, in the military culture, one of the most profound deeds you can carry out for a fellow soldier is to carry them off the battlefield. And that's, in a figurative sense, that's what we do here. We've had 3- and 4-star generals helping us carry those litters off the aircraft.
How's it feel to be surrounded by all your brothers getting you home safely?
It feels good. It's nice to know that everybody cares about you.
I'm not a young man, but when I'm coming down that ramp, there's kind of a lightness in my step, and I'm just focused on getting those soldiers off the aircraft safely and into the loving hands of the Air Force, medical personnel, and the entire support system here at Andrews.
When troops get here to Andrews, they go one of three places, either straight to Walter Reed or Bethesda Medical Center, or they stay overnight here and are airlifted out the next day to hospitals closer to home.
The troops end up in different places for treatment, but many are thinking the same thing.
Good to be home, or do you miss the guys over there already?
I still wish I could have finished up my deployment over there.
They come off the plane, maybe they've lost an arm or a leg, and their first question is, when can I go back to Iraq? When can I go back to finish the job?
But for now, their job is to heal, and the colonel's crew will be here to welcome them home, even those with wounds you cannot see.
We've had soldiers who, as we're carrying their litters off the ramp of the aircraft, will ask us to sit them down on the tarmac right there so they can touch U.S. soil.
Was that a training accident?
At Andrews Air Force Base, just outside D.C., Janelle Stelson, News 8.